Thank you for your question. The fact of the matter is I haven't campaigned on defund the police. There's one person up here that's been defunding our community that's caused crime to run rampant over the last 5 years. We've been defunding community centers. Our pools were closed this summer. We've been defunding senior and youth services. My plan is to free police to do police work, which is solving crime, investigating crime, and keeping our community safe.
To meet your objectives?
The first thing we do is we stop police from being dog catchers, homelessness outreach, mental health counselors, and we put professionals into those roles that is their job to do. We cut police overtime. We can end the militarization. We don't need tanks on the streets when people peacefully protest. There are lots of ways. And under a Walton administration, we're going to have a transparent budget process so that we'll be able to tackle those issues head on.
Mayor Brown, would you like to answer that question?
Yes. First, let me just say I did not get the full 2 minutes at the beginning. If you listen to how that went, I didn't get a full 2 minutes. But India Walton is completely wrong when she says she hasn't campaigned on defunding police. She said that she would cut $7.5 million from the police department budget, which is clearly defunding police, and that would result in 100 less police officers on the streets of this community. Also, the three most dangerous calls that police officers respond to, highly trained police officers, are domestic violence, are mental health calls, and traffic stops. Ms. Walton proposes to not have police engaged in any of those areas, putting citizens at risk to try to do those dangerous jobs.
Thank you, Mayor Brown. We don't have instant replay, so I was flexible on your answer to that. This was a personal attack on India Walton. We will just say that you have, Ms. Walton, you have 30 seconds to rebut what the mayor just said, but there is no counter rebuttal. You have 30 seconds.
The $7.5 million my opponent is referencing comes from a very good study that was put out by the Partnership for the Public Good that after a great audit of the police budget suggests that positions can be eliminated through attrition and the budget can be decreased by decreasing overtime and properly staffing the police department. That's not defunding. That's a responsible use of taxpayer dollars.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Walton. Next question posed by Lee Pettigrew of W.
That was an attack.
No, it wasn't. No. Mr. Miles, we're going to keep order here. That was not interpreted as a personal attack, Mayor. So we are going to move on to our next question. Mayor Brown, would you like to answer that question?
What Ms. Walton just said about the Fruit Belt Land Trust and her several years of managing that organization is just absolutely false. Public records show that the Fruit Belt Land Trust did not build a single house. So I'd like her to explain how she was such a successful executive director of the Fruit Belt Land Trust that built not one single house. So what she just said was completely false.
Now, Ms. Walton, you have 30 seconds.
I would love to respond. It's amazing that in your own city, you don't know what's going on. We definitely built two houses. The addresses are 162 and 166 Rose. We did it in partnership with Habitat for Humanity because we secured an $800,000 grant from Enterprise Community Foundation, and the city refused to let us pursue a bigger project. So we had to settle for two houses, and we had to partner with Habitat for Humanity on the demand of the city of Buffalo, which you forced us to pay market rate for city-owned land to build affordable housing that serves the public good. So let's talk about that.
Thank you, Ms. Walton. Mayor Brown, you have 30 seconds.
Yes, I want to come back to that fairy tale that Ms. Walton keeps telling about being a successful not-for-profit executive. Now we hear her saying she built two houses. That was your great success with the Fruit Belt Land Trust, two houses which she did not build. Habitat for Humanity built those houses, I asked the media to check the public record, and you will find it out. Now the Fruit Belt Land Trust is trying to buy those houses from Habitat for Humanity.
Thank you, Mayor.
So that they can say they did.
Thank you, Mayor.
Which they did not.
Mayor, now it's another personal attack on Ms. Walton, and that should end it. Ms. Walton, you have 30 seconds.
We could have done much more had we had the cooperation of the city of Buffalo. That is part of the reason why I'm running for mayor, because I know there are so many people who do such good work in this community, and the barrier we face time after time comes from the second floor of City Hall, and it's time that we end that right now.
Mayor Brown.
Yeah, I want to come back to Ms. Walton's role with the Fruit Belt Land Trust. Again.
Please.
Again. She had every requirement that any developer in the city of Buffalo has. When you buy property in the city of Buffalo, you have to buy it at appraised value. If you want to develop something, you have to follow the rules. Now she's trying to blame the second floor of City Hall for her ineptitude. She was not a success. She has to be honest. You talk about building two houses that you didn't build. If that's how you define success, I'm amazed.
Thank you, Mayor Walton. You have 30 seconds for a rebuttal.
It's interesting that today Mayor Brown wants to talk about what the rules are, since he is spending tons of money to skirt the rules. The fact of the matter is, as I said, we worked in partnership with Habitat for Humanity. We followed the rules set forth by your Office of Strategic Planning, and the state has put out an opinion paper that says you can't, in fact, dispose of land for below market rate when it's gone to use for public good. That's the state's opinion on it, Mr. Brown, and you should, well, you don't have to look into it anymore, but, you know, I want you to know that. City-owned land can't be used to develop affordable housing, and you can't dispose of it at below market rate.
Thank you, Ms. Walton. Ms. Walton?
I would support both federal and state legislation to have stricter gun control and also hold gun manufacturers liable for illegal guns coming into our community. But I think the most important way that we reduce violent crime is by increasing resources to communities, by increasing home ownership, by reducing poverty, by creating decent living wage jobs, to give our young people something to live for, some hope for the future, so that they're not out here in moments of desperation harming one another.
Mayor Brown?
Again, Ms. Walton shows her lack of experience and qualification for this job. She said that she would hold gun manufacturers liable. As mayor of the city of Buffalo, you can't hold gun manufacturers liable. What that activist who passed away, his name is Neil Dobbins, and he was a champion of this community, a champion for taking illegal guns off the street. He was pushing for the repeal of the Tehart Amendment. Which makes it impossible to trace guns and to provide that trace data to communities. That is what we need to see happen at the federal level. That amendment needs to be repealed because it has helped the proliferation of illegal guns on the streets of this city and cities all across America.
Thank you, Mayor Brown. Walton, you got 30 seconds.
By Mike, oh, there we go. I just want to clarify that what I actually said, had you listened, was that I support state and federal legislation that holds gun manufacturers liable, not that I would do it as mayor.
Thank you.
That's it came out of my mouth. I'm certain that's what I said.
Thank you.
We can play it back later.
Ms. Walton, Mr. Brown.
So tonight I feel like a three-way punching bag. I'm taking fire from all angles. But let me just say, during my time as mayor, state senator, Mass and district council member, I work 7 days a week for this community. I put 7 days a week in for this community. I've been knocking on doors all summer, too. And when I knock on doors, you know what people tell me? They don't know any of these people who are up on this stage with me. They don't know anything that they have done. And you know what the young people tell me about Ms. Walton? That her credits don't add up. that her references don't check out. This is not a job for on-the-job training. This is a job that takes experience.
Thank you, ma'am. Ms. Walton, you have 30 seconds to respond.
I mean, you've been mayor for 16 years. I would expect that everyone would know who you are, but the fact of the matter is that I won the Democratic primary. I'm not even sure why I'm standing up here with the three of you.
I'm sorry, Mayor, you have 30 seconds for a rebuttal.
Again, I don't know who this guy is, so I'm not even gonna comment on that. But just let me say, Ms. Walton again showed her lack of experience and lack of understanding of how the process works. When you win a primary, you don't win an election. Every election is a primary and general election. So yes, you are the Democratic nominee, but let's look at the results on November 2nd.
Thank you. Ms. Walton, you have 30 seconds.
Every primary in history has resulted in the presumptive next mayor. Because it's me, you want new rules created. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. You ran as a Democrat. You used to be the head of the state Democratic Party, and now you want to create a new party for a second chance when you should have just ran the first time.
Thank you, Ms. Walton.
Be real, before the American Rescue Plan was coming, we were at a $65 million deficit. We've had our rainy day funds spent down $100 million. We are not bringing in the ethical revenue to keep our city going. So unfortunately, we're gonna have to look at a modest incremental tax increase in order to balance our books.
So just so we're clear, no, no, and yes, you will raise taxes. Mayor Brown.
I'm glad, Ms. Walton.
His mic, please.
His mic.
Yeah, the mic not working.
I'm glad Ms. Walton admitted honestly that she's going to raise taxes on residents of the city of Buffalo. In fact, she said in an interview that she's gonna raise taxes by 3%. 3% is not a modest tax increase. If you own a $100,000 home in the city of Buffalo, that means an extra $300 a year. So she talks about fees and fines, which we've already eliminated 15 fees and fines in the city of Buffalo, but she wants to raise your taxes on the other hand. It's a shell game with Ms. Walton. She's making a false promise. It doesn't add up. And I'm glad today that she admitted she wants to raise taxes. During my entire tenure as mayor, we have either held the line on taxes or cut taxes in the city of Buffalo.
Ms. Walton, you have 30 seconds to respond.
Fines and fees were not eliminated under the mayor's own volition. It was the Fair Fines and Fees Coalition that did that work, and you were compelled to do it because the community outrage was so great that you didn't have any other choice. That is called political will. The exciting thing about me running for mayor is now people don't have to fight and scream in order for me to just do what's right. Yes, I'm going to be honest, and yes, I said there will be an incremental tax increase, and we are going to protect legacy homeowners the same way we did with Assemblywoman Crystal People Stokes in the Fruit Belt neighborhood. You remember that, right?